going to talk about Chinese Neolithic jade objects. I hope we will have enough time later to discuss some reasons for the differences between Europe and China. Let's begin with a brief overview. As you already know, both jadeite and nephrite are included into the term jade. Actually, only nephrite is relevant for China. Most objects are crafted from nephrite and its simulants, not from jadeite. At the very first point of differences, the material. The next one is the form. While European Neolithic jade objects are excess, Chinese Neolithic jade objects were various ritual objects, mostly not in weapon form. The function is not quite equal. As well, European jades as Chinese one served as prestigious objects for cultic and ceremonial purpose, but Chinese ones were great goods. Generally, most Chinese objects are found in burial context. European Neolithic jade objects were replaced through copper and bronze axes in the Chalcolithic, and subsequently jadeite axes found no use in Europe anymore. They fell into oblivion. Chinese Neolithic jade objects, in contrast, gave birth to the Chinese jade culture, which looks back on a continuous more than 7,000 years history and has remained the integral part of the value system in China to this day. Let us have a closer look at these points. As I think similar slides was already shown, so I just want to that you pay attention to this interlocking of short fibers. They make nephrite very tough, very hard to walk, very hard to break. Of course, jadeite and nephrite have fairly similarity. They are both silicate rocks, but their chemical compositions are different. So we will concentrate now only on nephrite. As can be shown on this map, Neolithic jade objects were found in very different areas within China. It looks like almost every China culture used Neolithic jade objects. You can see in this table Neolithic jade cultures, which are here chronological and geographical order. The earliest and the most influential are Xinglongwa and Lingjiatan, and from the later ones, the most important are Hongshan and Liangzhu. I will show you some of their jades later. The traditional Chinese word for jade, yu, refers to even more stones than English one. Hence, Wen and Jin suggest to distinguish between true himi, pseudo jades. Only true jades is nephrite. They conclude that 76% of archaeological jades they have analyzed were true jade, also nephrite. Chinese colleagues have already discovered some Neolithic jade sources. For example, Liangzhu culture use the material which was identified as nephrite with high portion of tremolite, I have forgotten to say it, most nephrite is formed from tremolite actinolite. The deposit of Liangzhu jade is a Xiao Meilin mine, Jiangsu province. We have example for another Chinese cultures, but generally we can say the mineralogical material of Chinese Neolithic jade was locally available stone. Of course, not only true nephrite, but its simulants as well. So now I would like to show you some example. We start with Xinglongwa culture. This is famous for their so-called jewel ring. It is slit earring, which has great influence, not only in China, but also in Japan and Korea. Of course, if I say China, Japan, I mean prehistoric areas, which now belongs to this country. I hope it's self-evident. The next is Lingjiatan culture. Archaeologists have excavated more than 1,000 jade pieces in only 66 tombs. In some 2,250 square meters of the site, but the site, archaeological site itself, is huge. It's about 1,006,000 square meters. So it will be probably find even more jades. So please have a look. And these two tombs. So the, on the left, it is one of Lingjiatan culture, and another one on the right is 2,000 years younger, belongs to Liangzhu culture. So only in one tomb, so many jade objects were found. Please pay attention to these very sophisticated forms of jade objects of Liangzhu culture. This is so-called song tube and B disc. We have no idea about the function. Most of song are fine decorated. You can see this example of decoration here. It's very sophisticated, very, very fine lines on nephrite. And I hope you can remember jewel ring of Xinglongwa. It is a further development. Hongshan culture is a successor of Xinglongwa. So in this table, some of jade's objects are compared. It is obvious many different Neolithic cultures in China shared the same motifs and shapes of jades. Analyzing jades, we shall finally be able to trace mining, production, and a social exchange network. Tool marks on many Neolithic jades give us clue about workmanship of jades. It is normally include follow steps: sawing, cutting, engraving, drilling, grinding, and finally polishing. It will be impossible without some abrasives. Now we know that Neolithic Chinese craftsmen used wood, garnet, corundum, and probably even diamond-containing gravel. It is just a suggestion because there's a couple of very seldom objects which contain corundum, and they are polished as mirror. You can see it on this slide. Now I come to conclusions. So jade in Neolithic China was a mineralogical material like nephrite and its simulants. Jade was used to create mostly ritual and ceremonial objects. Almost every Neolithic culture used ritual jade objects. The mineralogical material of Chinese Neolithic jade was a locally available stone, nephrite of different quality or its similars. Jade objects were generally found in burial context. Various Neolithic jade objects indicate already mature and complex faith systems and associated funeral rites. The differences in funeral inventory point to stratified society that seems to possess considerably human and natural resources, as well as well-functioning organizational system. Apparently, a division of labor and specialization took place already during the Neolithic period. In this regard, the question arises as how jade proceeding and usage played a role in the emergence and stabilization of Chinese civilization. Chinese jade culture lasts already over 7,000 years, in contrast to Europe. So questions will be answered later, I suppose. Thank you.